shark, leave the water as calmly and quickly as possible. Sharks are accustomed to attacking anything that floats, including boats. A boat offers little protection in the face of a determined shark. Thank you. While it is well known that sharks feed on mollusks, fish, and seals, less discussed is their propensity to feed on fear. Emphasize that this sort of targeted violence is quite unusual for a shark.
That shark is a good whack on their nose. Go get him, Chad.
Making a lot of flesh.
shock myself.
Ho, ho! Look at them teeth! Whoa! She gonna make quite a mantle piece!
Got us some dinner coming, boys! Let's get her up on deck, huh?
On board the Cajun Queen, Scaly Pete looks over the catch of the day.
Yeah, this my daddy's iron, all right. But this ain't the shark. Not the one I was looking for.
How do you know?
How I know? Not big enough. This look like a mega to you. She's on for me. Hello! How you mama in there?
Whoa! But why'd you do that?
So I can identify her next time I see her. When I spear her.
The tiny pup responds with an instinct for survival.
You never want to turn off that gamma.
A famous big game hunter once posited that after an animal had tasted human flesh, it forsakes its natural prey in a deadly single-minded search for the most dangerous game. Quite a strange conglomeration of stuff will end up in the stomachs of sharks. The bull retreats to the grotto for refuge and quiet reflection. Thank you. Exhibiting behavior more common to whales and dolphins, this shark is able to use biosonar to locate potential prey. Even half dead, the shark is still a potent menace to any and all living things. 400 million years of evolution, and yet the shark is eaten by someone's future luggage. The Fautic Bayou area has lost 63 acres of marshland due to saltwater intrusion. The muskellunge, or muskie, is a freshwater fish commonly found throughout the Great Lakes region, so I have no idea what it's doing here. I have one of those new pop-up tub stoppers at home, and let me tell you, those things are just a magnet for hair and debris. Is a freshwater fish commonly found throughout the Great Lakes region, so I have no idea what it's doing here.